Hello everyone, this is BCS Buster, and welcome back to Let's Play New Horizons. Last time we started the introduction for Otto's quest, and we defeated this sailor that's here in the bar, and he said that we're pretty tough, so... And apparently we're not too shabby ourselves, so... Yep, we are now the Commodore. How about working for me? Alright, now we get to sit down and have a bite to eat. Maybe later. I guess Otto's just ready to get going. Alright, so now he gets to be the first mate. Well, that was easy. Alright, and just like that, we've got a new guy on our team. Very cool. Alright, well, let's check him out. See how good he is. And I'll show you Otto's stats while we're at it, too. So, here's Otto. He's pretty good. Seamanship isn't great, but we can work on that. But he's got a battle level of 12, so that's going to be really helpful. And then let's check out our guy. He's not bad. I'm probably not going to use him, just because he has low seamanship. But he's not too bad. So, okay. Now, here in London, there's a couple guys that we can hire. And we're definitely going to want to pick those guys up. So this is the first one, Antoine Fitch. We definitely want to hire this guy. And that's going to help us get our cash flow going. Okay, good enough. And he's got bookkeeping skills. Oops. So we're definitely going to want to make him our bookkeeper. So we'll do that real quick. And he's now our bookkeeper. Sweet. One more guy we can hire here in London. And he's actually a really good character to have. I forgot to hire him in my alley walk. Well, I can't remember if I hired him in my alley walk through or not. I don't remember. But anyways, good character to have, and we should be able to get him. There he is, Lawrence Edwards. And he's another good guy to have. And no, that's too expensive. He'll go lower. Come on. Okay, whatever. I don't have patience. And we'll be making a good amount of money soon, so we'll be able to pay these guys. And we're going to want to make him our chief navigator, because we have that position available. So there we go. Okay, well, time to set sail. So we're going to go down here to the harbor. And here we go. All right, I'm not quite sure where we're going to go, but let's set sail anyway. And I'll just let the music play here for a little bit. Okay, got a scene here. Let's see. Where are we headed? That's a good idea. I wonder where we should go. A little spying on the enemy, okay? Let's course for Seville, okay? It's easy if you use the auto-sail command. Well, you can use the auto-sail command if you're new to the game. I personally don't like it because you don't go as fast. And if you talk to all these fleets, they're all going to say that they're on their way home. So we don't really need to talk to any of the fleets. And I'm just going to let the music play, the sprightly British music, if you will. Anyways, you get the idea of the music. So anyway, here's the port of Seville. We're going to stop here real quick. And find out what's going on here. Yes. And already you're getting a level up early in the game. That's excellent. Okay. Standard rule in New Horizons. Whenever you go to a port to advance the story, always go to the cafe. Oh, and there's a couple guys waiting for us. Excellent. There you are, Matthew. Yes. Okay, he's been waiting. Apparently Matthew likes to eat. But hey, who doesn't? I know you're hungry as I am. Okay, so we get to have a seat. And we've already been there for an hour. Okay. Why a man like us is sailing on a beat-up ship. Yeah, our ship sucks. Yeah. Well, Gilbert, yeah, that's kind of obvious. He kind of treated us pretty poorly. Yes, he is double-crossing. Dessert for five. Okay. Apparently, Matthew is somewhat of a glutton, but that's okay. A little while later. That was delicious. All right, then. We'll have to round up some more hearties, because apparently he can't tend to the ship. But Matthew. Is there anyone here that wants to sail with Commodore Baines?
Aye!
All right. Hear, hear. Yes, get our hands on a bigger ship. Sounds good to me. We'd need a galleon. Okay, let's get a galleon. That sounds easy. Get our hands on that new Spanish, a new Spanish beauty. What's he talking about? The newest galleon. There's a vessel waiting in the harbor. Okay. We could sink pirates with one shot. Nice. Would be ironic using a Spanish ship to beat the Spanish. Okay. Cool. But I don't see how we could possibly pull it off. All right. Okay, what is he gonna do? Yay! Okay, where's he going? Where's he going? I'm confused. Wait, where are you going? No, that's a good idea. I'm kind of wondering that myself. Okay, I think we can hire someone here in the cafe. I don't know if it'll let me do it, but yeah, we might be going to look after Matthew. Let's see. Have you seen my buddies? Sir, everyone's gone to the harbor. Okay, yeah, it won't let me come back in, so. But I think there's a guy that you can hire. I'll hire him a little later. Because I'll definitely be coming back to Seville. Okay, let's go to the harbor. But yeah, apparently we're in the cafe. Commodore, look at this. Apparently we stole the ship. All right, we just stole a new galleon. Weren't there guards all around? We told them that some female naval officer stole a ship. I wonder who that could be. Then we just tied up the rest and put him in the cargo bay. If any ship was going to have been stolen, it would have been this. Okay, we've just upgraded our ship. Nice. We've now stolen a ship from the enemy. Okay, let's get her out of here quickly before we get caught. And let's go. Okay, now we don't have time to talk to this guy, so. Okay. And, alright, let's check things out. Let's check out our new ship. Yeah, our ship has been now upgraded to a galleon. It's called Fools for some reason. But we've got 150 crew and 200 in food and water. And some guns to go with it. So, nice. Okay, I will meet you guys out on the high seas. And here we go. Okay. First thing we need to do is we need to reassign our crew. Because I don't like our crew setup. Okay, so it takes about 45 guys to run this ship. So we're going to do... Let's see, if we did 40, then maybe... Oops. Nah, I don't like that configuration. Let's do... Yeah, we'll do 40 and then 10, and then 50% for combat. That's pretty good. Yeah, that'll be good enough. Okay, now. Alright, another commentary here. Ah, good morning, Commodore, yes. Ah, Matthew, you finally woke up. So what did Otto do all night? It is a nice view. You'll be able to eat your way around the world. Nice. Man, I like this guy's attitude, though. You know, he likes to eat. That's a good thing. And you'll be happy to hear we'll be eating like kings with it. 10,000 gold pieces we found in the captain's cabin. Hey, we got a gold bar. Awesome. Time when I went and broke that weasel Gilbert's nose. Nice. Sounds like a good idea to me. I like it. Yep. Defeat the Spanish fleet. Which ship shall we attack first? It's just one ship. Yes, that's true. Okay, we'll have our feet swept out right from one underneath us. Okay. Of course, Matthew. Attack on some merchant ships. Yep, and that's a standard. That's a good way to build your experience, is attack merchant fleets. Attack the enemy's flagship, right? Absolutely. Cool, yeah. So viewers, if you're new to this, all you need to do is attack the flagship. You don't necessarily beat every ship, so that's good. We'll have nothing to worry about. You can either do it in a duo or by rushing. Okay, viewers, well, I'm not going to have time to show you the next part of the game, which is a battle, so I'm going to go ahead and stop here. Next time, we will start some battles with Otto's Quest, and we will get the game underway. But until then, this is BCS Buster signing off. Take care, y'all.